So today we keep our march through the book of Luke. We're now at the end of chapter 6. And as I said last week, we have been in what is called the Sermon on the Plain for the last couple weeks. It's very similar to the Sermon on the Mount that we find in Matthew, but it's a different place and a different sermon. So they call this one the Sermon on the Plain. And Jesus finishes up this sermon today with a question, a very important question, and also a very important challenge. So let me read this scripture to you, and then we'll jump right in. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not do what I say? As for everyone who comes to me and hears my words and puts them into practice, I will show you what they are like. They are like a man building a house who dug down deep and laid the foundation on the rock. When a flood came, the torrent struck that house, but could not shake it because it was well built. But the one who hears my words and does not put them into practice is like a man who built a house on the ground without a foundation. The moment the torrent struck that house, it collapsed and its destruction was complete. Let's pray. God, we pray that you would teach us this morning what I see as a very important passage of scripture. We pray that you would help us as we consider those things upon which we build our lives. Lord, speak to us in a clear and powerful way today. We ask in Christ's name, amen. So Jesus is saying something, a number of things that are really important in this parable, actually two little parables, two stories side by side. And it's this question, what are you building your life upon? That's the question he asks. He's saying we all build our lives. We're all in the midst of building lives. We have a philosophy of life. We have values. We have relationships. We have commitments, and what Jesus does in this very important passage of scripture, and honestly, a very influential passage in my life, he asks us the question, what life are you building? And upon what are you building your life? And he does this, he asks this question by telling two little stories. Actually, this is two stories and not one parable. It's two stories side by side with some things that are very much in common and then something that is very different. He says, two men went out to build a house. And one went out and spent some time digging deep and going all the way down to the rock. You know, Palestine is very much like California, if we were to go out in one of these riverbeds in Southern California, same thing, a lot of sand, not a lot of vegetation. And so he dug down deep and built his foundation on the rock. That's the first man. The second man goes out, and you know, just like the weather in Palestine is very much like Southern California. What looks like a nice place to build a house in the summer can be not so nice in the winter. Unfortunately, isn't it great that we're getting this rain? So if you went out to build a house in a riverbed that looked dry in the summer, well, long dry summers, intense winters, that's Palestine, that's California sometimes. Wow, if you don't go down deep, well, first of all, pick a nice place to build a house, but then dig down deep and put it on a rock, on a foundation. Well, he doesn't do that. So the storm comes and hits both of these houses. And one is completely ruined, destroyed. And the other holds up. So what is Jesus saying here in this passage? Well, I think, first of all, he tells us that what we build our lives upon is really important, and we all have something that we're building our lives upon. We all have some sort of foundation or something that we, upon which we build our lives. Now, for many years, I studied this parable, and I kind of struggled. What is Jesus talking about when he talks about a foundation or about something upon which we build our lives? What is it exactly that he's talking about? Well, you know, I found, in a couple secular books, I kind of got some ideas about this. One of the books is called Seasons of a Man's Life, first book ever written about male development, about different stages of adult development for males. It's written by a guy named Daniel Levinson. And he talks about a person's foundation or a person's life structure. And he says, everybody has one. Every man has one. And it's kind of what he describes as the fabric of our lives. The thing that kind of holds it together, that weaves it together. And he says these can change from time to time in our lives. It's relationships and commitments and values. In fact, here's what's interesting about this book. He says there are certain times in a man's life, and I'm sure in a woman's life, where they, and it's like clockwork, let me tell you, where a man comes to a certain age, and they look at the fabric of their life. Oftentimes, it's because they realize life doesn't go on forever. This is the midlife crisis, is one of these. So you realize, wow, my life, you know, I'm getting through it. And you examine the fabric of your life, your marriage, your family, your career, all those things. And you make the decision, do I like the fabric of my life? Or do I want to change it? Sometimes people change it dramatically. They get the red Corvette. I hope nobody has a red Corvette that's like 50 years old. And they leave their wife. And they marry a younger woman, all really dealing with mortality, honestly. But you see that? It's this, you examine your life, your fabric. Now, another book I read that I think does a great job of describing this is a book I mentioned last week. Stephen Covey's book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, number one New York bestseller book for a number of weeks. And in this book, one of the habits that Covey talks about is you have to think about the center of your life. He calls it the center. What is the center of your life? And he describes it this way, which I think is really what Jesus is talking about. He says, whatever is at the center of your life will be the source of your security, your guidance, your wisdom, and your power. Security is your self-esteem, your self-worth, your identity, your anchorage. Wisdom is your perspective on life, your sense of balance, your understanding of how all the various parts and principles of life apply and how they relate to each other. It embraces judgment and discernment, comprehension. Guidance means the thing that guides you in life, your source of direction in life, standards or principles or values that govern moment by moment decision making and doing. And then finally, power, which I think is really interesting. Power is the thing that gets you up in the morning. Your faculty or capacity to act, the strength and potency to accomplish something, to keep going. It's the vital energy to make decisions and choices, and it's the capacity to overcome bad habits and make good decisions and cultivate higher, more effective habits. Do you see what Covey is saying here? That's pretty comprehensive, isn't it? It's the center of our life, and he says, you better pick your center carefully. And what he says is, you have to have principles as your center, which I'll get back to in a second. But that's your center. You could call it your foundation, whatever it is you build your life upon. Now, you may be thinking right now, what is my foundation? I hope you are. Because that's what Jesus is trying to get us to think about here. What is it that you build your life upon? What is it that people build their lives upon today in our culture? Well, obviously, materialism, definitely. One of the things that people, that is their center. Whether it's a house, a car, vacations, it's the thing that makes life worth living. It's the thing that gets you up to go to work in the morning. It's, for many people, materialism, what they own, the house they live in, the car they drive, it gives them security. Their sense of self-worth. For others, it could be your career, climbing up the ladder, many men in our culture, as Levinson writes in his book, this is it. This is the center. Power, achievements. What's interesting in Covey's book is he lists all these centers and kind of drawbacks and positives for him. He says church life, church activity can be a center. Now that's different than what we're going to talk about today. But church activity, he says an enemy can be the center of your life. Not a very good center. Family. Oh, something that we really value, as we should, can be the center. Your children, your spouse, relationships, all these different things can be the center or the foundation, the thing upon which you build your life. We all have something, is what Jesus is saying. We're all building a life. Second truth Jesus teaches us in this parable is this. What we build our lives upon is very important. Oh, very important. Maybe the most important decision we make. What is the center of your life? Now, in this parable, Jesus, remember, he's a carpenter. So he knows something about building houses. And he's drawn upon his experience. He knows that you better get the foundation right. You know, I worked on a construction crew a little bit right after college. I decided to stay in Santa Barbara. Who wouldn't, right? And I didn't know really what I wanted to do. I wasn't ready to go to grad school. I was still trying to figure out life, and I was in love with a girl who was still in school. So I stayed in Santa Barbara, and I got a job on a construction crew. And I remember we'd meet at a little restaurant. Remember that Sambo's in Santa Barbara? We'd meet there. Now there, that takes you back a little bit, huh? And we decide where we were going to go that day. We had a couple different projects, and so my boss said, hey, who would like to go work on this beach house down in Montecito? And I thought, duh. Of course. Beautiful day, beautiful beach, right on the beach. Didn't know what we were going to do, but I went down there, and then I found out what we were doing. This house's foundation was being eroded. It was crumbling. Here's this beautiful house. I mean, it looked fine to me, but it was about to become worthless because the foundation was crumbling. So you know what I had to do? I had to crawl under the house with a shovel for a week. The fifth day, I definitely heard the call from God to go into the ministry. That was hard work. And I was thinking about this week. I thought, wow, what if that thing had collapsed on me? But I'm sure it was fine. But here it is. Oh, this is a good little parable right here. Beautiful house. Everything looks like it's going well, but oh boy. It's about to crumble. Important what we build our house. And we know this in California, don't we? We not only build a foundation, bolt your house to that foundation. We see it in the San Francisco, in the Golden Gate Bridge. Amazing structure. What makes that thing withhold the winds that come through the Golden Gate? It's those two towers are going right down to bedrock. One, even on the San Andreas Fault, right on top of it. But they've dug down deep. So what we build our house on is a very, very important decision. The third thing that Jesus teaches us in this parable is we will all experience storms in life. We're all going to get hit by a storm. Both builders. It's not debatable. It's not debatable in our lives, is it? We will all experience storms. We don't know when they're coming. We don't know what form they're going to take, whether it's financial, whether it's a mistake that we make, a moral failure, health issues. You know, if nothing else, if you kind of cruise through life unscathed, you are going to face the storm of death. I can guarantee that one. We're all going to hit it, or it's going to hit us. Jesus is very realistic here. Remember, he's speaking to his disciples, people who have heard this sermon, and he is telling them, you know, just because you follow me doesn't mean you're going to be exempt from the storms of life. We all are going to get hit by the storm. So we all have something upon which we build our lives. We know that what we build our lives upon is very important, and we will all experience storms. Both people in this story experience that. Now, here's the differences. Obviously, one of the differences is what the builders chose for their foundation or what they built their house upon. The wise builder, what? Jesus makes it very clear, made the teachings of Christ his foundation. And this is what Jesus is trying to get across to these folks and to us. He does this, gives this great sermon, and then he gets to the end and he goes, so what? Which every sermon should have a so what. He went to a good seminary. Good homiletics professor. So what? Well, the so what is you build your life on my teachings. Another way of saying that is you enter into a trusting relationship with Christ. We not only hear the words, but we act upon them. We trust Christ with our lives. You know, interesting that I think sometimes, you know, this is a familiar parable, obviously. We've heard it since we were little kids, if we've gone to Sunday school. Sometimes we think that one of the hearers isn't a follower of Christ. No, he's speaking to followers of Christ. Both, everyone there is a disciple. One hears, but doesn't really listen, doesn't really follow what Christ is challenging him to do. The other does. He acts upon Christ's teaching. And we don't know why the one didn't. Maybe he lets his priorities get confused. Maybe he doesn't really see the importance. Maybe he gets distracted. Perhaps he thinks it will cost him too much. Whatever the reason, he hears the words and perhaps even believes. And see, this is where the warning comes in. But he doesn't act upon them. He doesn't make Christ really the center of his life. His Christianity is intellectual knowledge, but nothing else. It's not a heartfelt trusting day to day in Christ. Christ is not the center of his life. Christ is not the foundation. Now, the other obvious difference is the outcome. You know, one house gets hit by the storm and falls apart. It's destroyed. The other stands firm. And this brings us to the primary point of the parable. There's always one main point in a parable, and here it is. It's a bold claim by Christ. What he's saying in this parable is, you know what? The only true foundation, the only thing upon which to build your life that will withstand all the storms of life and will hold firm is me. That's a bold statement. It's my teachings. Everything else, they may be nice on the outside. They're nice things, but don't build your life on them. For example, think about this. You build your life on your job. I have a friend, a good friend, who built, one of my best friends, built his life on his job. Oh, it was a fulfilling career. He was moving up the ladder. He was doing well. He was getting paid well. He enjoyed it. He believed in it, all the rest. It was the center of his life. It was his foundation. And he was on a business trip, and his boss was staying a couple rooms down from him, and he got up late at night for some reason, and here was a female fellow employee coming out of his boss's room. He got fired not soon after. Wow. He got fired because he knew about this, right? Unfair. Went in total depression. Why? Because his job was his source of his security, his identity, his self-worth. He based his decisions on how it would guide his job, what effect it would have on his job. It was his power. It's what got him up in the morning, gave him the power to live life. All that was taken away. He said, Steve, I'll never forget sitting with him, having a drink, talking about this. He got, never again will I make my job the center of my life. A relationship, what can happen? You make your wife as beautiful as she is, your husband as charming as he is, which I know all the men in here are very charming. You know, people, relationship can break, it happens. People can die. You see what Jesus is saying? Even your family, it's not a rock solid foundation. Everything else can be swept away. And Jesus is saying, boy, be careful. Think about what you build your life on. What's the center? What's the fabric? I am the only true foundation. You know, I go over this sometimes in premarital counseling with couples. I'll read this parable. I usually use the one from Matthew, and I'll say, what's your foundation? What's the center of your life? Because, boy, as two people come together, if their centers are radically different, could be a problem. I remember one young man told me roller hockey was the center of his life. He thought about it for a while. He goes, you know, it is. It's the center of my life. And I said, you know, it's not a great foundation. Not a great foundation. You can blow out your knee. You have kids, you're not going to be able to play roller hockey anymore. Only one foundation. Very strong conclusion. Jesus challenges us to examine our lives, to think about what have we built our lives upon? What's going to give us security and wisdom and guidance and power throughout all the changes and all the storms of life? Let me close with this story. When I was a little boy, you may remember these, the 1045 service, I don't think is going to remember these. Remember those they were kind of blow-up punching bags? And you'd hit them, and they'd fall down, right? And then what? Bounce back up. Now, I used to get so mad at that thing. I'd hit it, and it'd go down, and back up. And mine was a clown with a big smile. It was almost taunting me, you know? But hit it, bounce back. Hit it, bounce back. Hit it, bounce back. Wow. You know why? Because at the base is a weight. In fact, I think it was sand. So we'd go over, but oh, that weight would bring it back up. Jesus in this story is saying, you know, I'm the base, and the storms are going to hit, the punches are going to come. You're going to get hit. But boy, I can bring you back up over and over and over. Amen. God, we thank you for this amazing story and just all that is in such a simple story. We thank you that you are the true foundation, the only foundation that can give us life, that can give us power, that can give us forgiveness when we make mistakes. It has the flexibility and the strength to help us get through all of life. Lord, may this be a reminder to all of us or a challenge to examine our lives and to really think through what is it that is at the center of my life. In Christ's name we pray, amen.